Research Method Introduction Program organized by Nepal Ayurveda Medical Society NAMS. Today we will discuss about concept of research methodology in Ayurveda with a special purview on Ayurveda literature review. Without delaying anymore, let me welcome our research person for this session, Dr. Saurav Kokatnur, Associate Professor, Department of PG and PhD Studies in Samhita and Siddhanta Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya and Hospital, Hubli, Karnataka, India. As we have requested through the email to keep Charak Samhita book beside you, I would also like to confirm if all of you have a copy of it with you, right? I'd like to remind you of some basic rules for this program. Please do not turn on audio, video, or share screen during the presentation. Also, do not annotate on the share screen. You can put your questions in the chat box. If you have any queries regarding the topic, it will be addressed at the very last of the class. Let me welcome our sir, Dr. Saurav Kokatnur. The stage is yours.
Sir, you are not audible.
Now?
Yes, sir. Now
yes,
it's okay.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Should we start?
Yeah.
Shall we begin?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Adyatanam Swavarnashramochitam Deshakala Vasthochitam Nitya Naimittika Kamya Karma यथा शक्ति यथा ज्ञप्ति यथा वैभवम् करिष्ये मदाज्ञा कार्यभिः विद्या संबंधेभिः देह संबंधेभिश्च त्वदीयैः अशेष जनैः त्वत् सर्व कर्तृत्व कारयित्रत्वाद् अनुसंधान पूर्वकम् कारयिष्ये च उपस्थिताः सर्वे विद्वज्जनस्य चरणारविन्दयोः साष्टांगं प्रणिपत्य श्रोत्रोणां अभिवादनं पूर्वकं अत्र जिज्ञासु विषयक चर्चा प्रारंभं कुर्मः। The topic which I am asked to talk for today on this floor is research methods, in particular literature related research activity and research protocol. So generally it is known as literary research. So what is research and what are the types of research? I hope the previous speaker to me, that is yesterday, might have conveyed, and you may be knowing a good information on that particular issue. In continuation to it, it is very, very important to do the research work over literature, particularly for an Ayurvedic field. Research in general means a lot. What is research? Re is repeated, search and searching for the knowledge. So that is why clubbed re and search together, it is known as research. So repeated searching for some valid factor which is not existing prior to this, or which may be already existing and we want to update it and bring it to the present day, that would be generally known as research. What Ayurveda tells about the research on this particular issue, that is the question for the thought. So Ayurveda also whether considers the research or not, whether Ayurveda did any research to get itself called as the science of life, healing hands, holistic science, medical science, challenging science for the treatment aspect. To get these well-known words to the head of Ayurveda, there must be a research which is carried out already in the beginning by ancestors, documented, and now it is being revalidated. Whether is it so or not is the big question for everyone to comment over Ayurveda and a life science. Is it true or not in all its sense? So whether any research activities carried out in the field of Ayurveda or not becomes a very big question. Alternate science, I am using the word purposefully. Ayurveda is not the alternate science for anything. Ayurveda is native science. Other science which emerged later in the recent era may be taking a highest path, we'll call this particular traditional science as alternate. But for we, the one who are followers of Ayurveda, should not accept this and should say that Ayurveda is native science, the remaining everything is alternative science. For those people, their science is native, remaining everything is alternate. But ours, for us, at least it is not so. When we say this, there will be definitely a question by scholars, experts. What is the proof for you to say that Ayurveda is healing from its root of the disease and giving better result over any other science? Because most of the medical science which are existing right now definitely have one or the other way the hindrance, side effects, what we generally call. Do we think Ayurveda is the only science which has no side effect, or allopathy is the only science which has maximum side effect? These words attributed for the science, maybe allopathy or Ayurveda, that the side effect or adverse reaction, which is made a market word, it's a marketing word for an Ayurveda, they say no side effect, pure herbal, pure Ayurvedic, absolutely zero side effect, 100% disease cure from the root. This is where we are failing. If we say there is no adverse effect of Ayurveda, then we are not Ayurvedians. We are not the true Ayurveda lovers or true Ayurveda practitioners. A science, when it is said, particularly the health science, it is called practice. Never it is called perfect. That is why allopathic science or allopathic way of treating, they say he is so and so a cardiology practitioner. He is practicing it. He is not perfect. Whether such terminology is existing with us or not would be the question. So these type of various basic, very basic questions to substantiate that Ayurveda is definitely a science, in particular a health science, which is equivalently important for any individual in the universe to believe and get benefit of this particular holistic science to the best possible core. So whether this practice related word what allopathy uses, do we have any reference in our science, whether the science said once you have read, you completed BAMS and you are perfect, whether the Ayurveda in any way, anywhere, has it mentioned? Nowhere it is mentioned. Satada dhyanam vadaha paratantra avalokanam. The Granthakara narrates how a physician, how a vaidya should be. He says, satata dhyanam vadaha. He must be reading continuously, must be referring the text, various concepts regularly. Vadaha, he has used one important word, that is vadaha. What is this vada? He must interact with the scholar who has equal knowledge so that the doubtful factors are clarified and a particular conclusion can be drawn out of that particular conversation. Hence, vada is used. Paratantra avalokanam. I am an Ayurvedic scholar, pure follower of Ayurveda. I don't want to see anything other than Ayurveda. If we say this, then also Ayurveda has insisted and said, you are not at all a fit person for getting called yourself as an Ayurvedic doctor. So great information has been given, propagated from ages to the scholars who are present right now. And it will be propagated from us to the scholars who are coming in future even. So by considering these all factors, we must try to analyze Ayurveda in depth. Coming to the particular topic which I am allotted, that is literary research or research in the literature of an Ayurveda. If we consider this, the literary research or research over literature of various Ayurvedic scripts, then it is very, very important to know how literary research should be carried out. Whether the research aspect is available with Ayurveda or not would fall again the first question. To see that, we must refer various samhitas, various pages, various sthanas, and various concepts explained in our Shastra Granthas. I had requested the host to inform every viewer to be present with Charaka Samhita, at least with the Purvartha. So in Vimanasthana 8th chapter, if you have Chakrapani Tika from Chokamba publication, then I can give the page number. Or else, if you have your own texts of various publications from your country, then you can, I'll give the chapter number, sthana, as well as quotation number, you can refer there. So, go to what is called as Vimanasthana 8th chapter, Vimanasthana 8th chapter, that is about the concept of Siddhanta. So, the quotation number is 37. I am repeating, Vimana, chapter 8, quotation number 37. It is saying, may I have anyone who can tell whether you are getting what I am telling about the pages and quotation? Is Lochan available?
Anyone, please unmute yourself.
Yeah, someone can let me whether what the reference I'm giving, are you able to find it out?
Yes, sir.
Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, Vimana 8, quotation number 37, it says, Atha Siddhantaha. सिद्धांतो नाम स यः परीक्षकैः बहुविधं परीक्ष्य हेतुभिश्च साधयित्वा स्थाप्यते निर्णयः. सो दिस सिद्धांत इज फाइनल कंक्लूजन. यत् सिद्धं तदेव अंतम्. वॉट एवर इज स्टडीड इन मल्टीपल एंगल बाय मल्टीपल पर्सनालिटीज and their conclusion what we draw out of the study, detailed study, that particular concept is called Siddhanta. It is established theory. Siddhanta, it means established theory. So, quotation number is 37. Vimanasthan, quotation number 37, chapter 8. Right. So what this Siddhanta word being defined by Granthakara in our Samhitas, he says, Sa yaha parikshakaihi. Parikshakaihi, again he is using Bahuvachana. Pariksha hetubhischa sadhayitva. Not one parikshaka. He would have used parikshakaha, but he is using parikshakaihi, Bahuvachanam. Why? The Siddhanta, to be called as Siddhanta, it should travel multifactorial, multicentric, multiple experts putting their effort in establishment of any theory. So, Parikshaka are multiple, multiple places and multiple way they are being tested, and whatever the conclusion each examiner draws out of their study is collected, compiled and statistically analyzed. So that is called Siddhanta. So Ayurveda Siddhanta, there are so many Siddhantas. We'll go to Charaka Sutra, first chapter, Charaka Sutra Sthan, first chapter. There, the concept of... You can go to Charaka Sutrasthan, first chapter, quotation number 28. Charaka Sutra 1, quotation number 28. Samanyancha visheshancha gunan dravyani karmacha samavayancha tadnyatva tantrokta vidhim asthitaha. So what Granthakara is saying there, there are six padartha. It is called shat karana dravya or shat karana padartha. What are they? Samanyancha visheshancha gunan dravyani karmacha samavayancha tat jnatva tantrokta vidhim asthitaha. What is vidhi? There is particular ritual or a rule for framing the words, to keep the words. Mind you, when Granthakara is writing any quotation, whatever the word he uses at the beginning has more importance, and whatever he is using at the last is kept at the last only. You cannot interchange it. Here, Samavaya he has used at the last. samavaya he has used at the last. That means samavaya importance at particular in respect to samanya and vishesha is least. Least in the sense comparatively. It definitely has its own importance. But samanya has more clinical importance. Same way, when we are studying padartha vijnana, we study about tarka sangraha. From tarka, tarka shastra has accepted 7 bhava padartha. 6 bhava padartha and 1 abhava. Totally 7 padartha are there. Dravya, guna, karma, samanya, vishesha, samavaya, abhavaha, sapta padarthaha. That is what is tarka says. But the order in tarka sangraha or tarka shastra is starting from dravya. But the order in Ayurveda shastra starts from samanya. When you have a particular case in front of you, say ushna, say jwara. A person suffering with tivra jwara, that means what are you understanding? Tapa or ushna guna vriddhi in the deha. Samanyataha, ushnausha is present in every individual, that is known as tapa or tapa, in the form of ushma, which is produced by the jatharagni as well as dhatvagni, during their proper karma, annapachana or poshaniya dhatu amsha pachana. So this particular factor or the karma produces tapa, which is circulated all over the body, and throughout the body there will be a sudden amount of ushnausha present. When a person ingests any dravya which has agneya guna pradhana in it, that agneya guna mixes with the agni mahabhuta of jataragni or agni mahabhuta present in the jataragni, and due to the similarity there will be aggravation. Whether dravya aggravated, to say agni vriddhi, you must be consuming agni itself. Are you? No. Agni vriddhi is seen by the samanya guna. Hence, samanya is placed in the beginning. Later on guna. Next comes the vishesha. Why vishesha? Vishesha is similarly. Same quality, similarity between two objects, when united, there will be vriddhi. When dissimilar qualities are united, there will be kshaya. Hence, samanya and vishesha are placed at the beginning, later on guna before dravya. First, you will be understanding the samanya guna. Yes. Agni Mahabhuta or Agni Guna, Agneya Guna is Vriddha in Jvarita Vyadhita. So it is Samanya of Agni Guna, Agni Tattva. Now we have to do Vishesha, that is Shi Tattva. To bring Vishesha so that Jvara Shanti takes place, we are thinking that we have to create some Vishesha. What that Vishesha? Shita Guna Prayoga, Ushnasya Virodhaha Shitaha. So, guna is placed at the third. How do you achieve the shita guna vriddhi, or by giving shita guna to the individual, jara shanti takes place? By what are you saying, collect the shita guna and take it? No. To induce shita guna, we are using dravya. Hence, after guna, dravya is established or dravya is placed. With this dravya, how are we understanding whether dravya is acting by its own? No, it is acting by its guna, as well as that is seen by the karma. Whether guna is acting or not, whether dravya is doing its function of creating vaishishtyata or not, is understood by the karma of that particular dravya in that particular individual. Hence, karma is placed. Later on, samavaya is placed. All five we can understand, but the difficulty comes with samavaya. What this samavaya, how do we understand in chikitsa? Here the samavaya means samavayaha. The quotation is explained again later on in the same chapter. Samavayaha aprithak bhavaha bhumyadinam gunaihi mataha sa nityam yatrahi dravyam na tatra niyato gunaha. So this samavaya is understood by guna and dravya with the karma. Guna is ashrita in dravya, karma is ashrita in guna as well as dravya. You cannot take karma out of dravya or guna out of dravya. You cannot. But this factor is coming at the later stage for our understanding. Hence, samavaya is placed at the last. So, started with samanya, we start thinking which guna is common. To reduce that agneya guna, we thought of bringing some visheshata. So, vishesha comes next. How do we induce this vaishishtya? For that, we need shita guna, hence guna comes. How can we exhibit shita guna in particular individual? There we are supposed to use dravya. How this dravya is acting to bring vishishtata by this particular guna so that the jvara shamana takes place, we understood by its karma. And this guna, dravya, karma, they are residing with samavaya sambandha. Hence samavaya we understood at the later. This sort of study of each word of the Samhita, why is it placed at the beginning and why at the later, is particular type of literary research. So this is again a type of literary research. So whether this type of research is carried out by Atre Punarvasu and all the Shishyas, Agniveshascha Bhelascha Jatukarana Parasharaha Harita Kshara Jagrostan Munervacha. Whether these six, they just tried to listen and they documented. Is it so? No. We'll go back again to Charaka Samhita Sutrasthan first chapter. Sutra Sankhya 8. Sutra Kramank 8. Charaka Sutra 1, chapter 1, Sutra 8. It is Angira Jamadagnishcha Vasishta Kashyapo Bhruguhu Atreyo Gautamaha Sankhyaha Pulastayoho Narado Asita. What Granthakara says, you can see the quotation, the list of Rishimuni is being narrated. These are all examiners. They are all various experts. They have studied various concepts and they all have united at the particular place called Parshve Himavataha Shubhaha. So they united at a particular place, Himalaya, and they started discussing about what? Why are we suffering with Vyadhi? Why are we suffering with various diseases which is making us unable, non-capable to perform our day-to-day activity? When this question was raised, they started thinking and they tried to find out. Later the quotation, you can go down. Dharmartha kama mokshanam arogyam mulamuttamam rogaha tasya apahartaraha shreyasaha jivitasya cha. Same, you can go down. Quotation number 15. Quotation number 15. So what it says, for arogya, to have good health, the moola is four: dharma, अर्थ काम मोक्ष एंड बाय फॉलोइंग द रिचुअल्स ऑफ धर्म प्राकृत अर्थ प्राकृत काम एंड दैट विल लीड टू मोक्ष. This, if we follow these four with the intention, whatever is explained as it is, that itself is known as arogya. And which type of arogya it is? Uttamaha sadarogyam. Sat shabdaha uttamam bruyat. Upanishad says this. So sat is uttama. Uttama arogya we can get. What is this uttama arogya? उत्तम आरोग्य इज श्रेयः. श्रेयः इज द उत्तम आरोग्य. व्हाट इज दिस श्रेय? श्रेय इज मोक्ष. श्रेयो नाम मोक्षः. एंड अगेन फॉर रोग अपहरण, रोगः तस्य अपहर्तारः. इफ ऑलरेडी अक्वेंटेड विद सम व्याधि, देन व्हाट आर वी सपोज्ड टू डू? धर्म अर्थ काम मोक्ष. हाउ? मोक्ष मीन्स लिबरेशन, साल्वेशन. व्हाट आर यू टॉकिंग? द क्वेश्चन कम्स. इट इज नॉट सो. हियर धर्म इज आहार धर्म, विहार धर्म, ग्राम्य धर्म, अवस्था धर्म, ऋतुकालीन धर्म, शिष्य धर्म, आचार्य धर्म, ज्ञान धर्म. सो मेनी धर्म आर देयर. We are not following. We did not follow properly ahara dharma. We got the disease. Vihara dharma we didn't follow properly. We are affected with the disease. So, to get relief from the disease, what we are already existing, we need to follow the dharma. To follow dharma, what do we need? We need artha. Artha is not only in the meaning of money. Here artha means particularly in case of disease, the artha means what you are supposed to consume and what not. That itself would be artha. Next comes the kama. What is the kama here? Here swarga kamo yajet. Why yajna are being done? To attain salvation, that is to have place in swarga, we perform yajna. And all yajna must be performed with the kamana, with the intention that we must get the swarga. Swarga means moksha. Apunarbhava vidyate. So, here the kama is roga nivritti. What is in swarga? What is there in swarga? Sakala savabhagyam. Sarva sukham in swarga. So, that sarva sukha nirogavastha, eating whatever we want to the particular trupti, enjoying the life, no pain, no sorrows, these are there in the swarga. So relief from the vyadhi itself is swarga. So swarga praptyartham kamana kratva, that is kama. Now what is moksha? If we perform dharma and artha and kama in particular way, in proper way, then roga nivritti itself is moksha. Mokshaha apunarbhavaha uchyate. What sort of moksha is it? Apunarbhava rupi. Once it has come, we are doing all activities properly. Due to those proper activities done by us, the roga moksha takes place, roga mukti takes place. This roga mukti is in such a way that it will never ever come. अपुनर्भवः मोक्षो रजस्तमो अभावात् बलवत् कर्मसंक्षया वियोगः सर्वसंयोगः अपुनर्भवरुच्यते. इन शरीरस्थान फर्स्ट चैप्टर इट इज एक्सप्लेन बाय चरक संहिताकार. व्हाट ही सेज? अपुनर्भवः, रिपीटेड अफेक्शन विद द डिसीज शुड नॉट बी देयर. दैट इज व्हाट इज मोक्ष. सो सच स्टडी टू गेट सच पर्टिक्युलर ट्रीटमेंट प्रिंसिपल्स, these rishis, Angira, Jamadagni, Vasishta, Kashyapa, Bhruguhu, all these rishis, 27 rishigana has been narrated They all had been gathered at a particular place and they started discussing. Later on, you know the story that Bharadwaja, who was knowing Vimanayana, Vimana Vidya, who went to Swarga, there he studied from Indra and he came back. So this is particular literary study. Pratyaksharam, Pratipadam, Aneka Akuti Garbhitaha Pratibhati Sudha. Athapi Vishayal Patvayan Ochati. Each Akshara, each Shabda, and each Vakya of Grantha has n number of meaning. But to make Grantha small, limited information is being given. Though literary research would be each alphabet, what it means. Akaya Pravisam Bhuma Ha Aha. Narayana Vachaha. A means Narayana. Ka means Narayana. Ka means Jnana. Ka means Brahma. Ka means Pratakkala. So many meanings are there. When it is said, any word is used with ka as the beginning, to that particular adhikarana, we are supposed to understand. So that is what is known as literary research. So this is basic knowledge about the literature. Now we'll go for another sutra from Charaka Sutrasthan, second chapter, quotation number 16. Charaka Sutra, chapter number 2, quotation number 16. What he says there, Matra Kala Shrayaha Yuktihi, Siddhihi Yuktau Pratishthitaha, Tishthati Upari Yuktidnyaha, Dravya Jnana Vatam Sada.
Wow, you can really dance.
Sir, you have been on mute yourself. Please unmute.
So in Charaka Sutrasthan, second chapter, he says, Vaidya is one. Which Vaidya is to be called supreme? He says, Matra Kala Shraya Yuktihi. Siddhihi Yukta Pratishthitaha. Tishthati Upari Yukti Jnaha. Dravya Jnana Matam Sada. Matra and Kala are Ashrita over Yukti. How much Guruji Churna should be given in Jvara is based on the Yukti of Vaidya. When to give? Prag Bhakta, Uttara Bhakta, Muhur Muhu. It depends on the Yukti, the logic of the Vaidya. So, Matra and Kala are Ashrita over the Yukti. Siddhihi Yuktau Pratishthitaha. Yukti is based or it is dependent on the Siddhi. If he has studied well about the Aushadha Sevana Kala, then he can discriminate. About the Roga, if he has studied, he can understand which dosha is Pradhana and Aushadha should be given in particular dosha Prabalya Avastha. If he doesn't know the Aushadha Sevana Kala, how can he? So, Yukti is dependent on Siddhi. Tishtadi Upari Yukti Jnaha. And there is something which is beyond the Yukti, that is Dravya Jnana Matam Sada. I know Yukti. Say, in Jvara Vyadhita, if it is Apana Vaigunya Janya Jvara, then Guruchi must be given. But when it is to be given, that is the Yukti. By Yukti, I can understand what it should be when it is due to Apana Vata. It should be given in the Pragbhakta Kala. Apane Pragbhaktam. So, I will give Guruji Churna in the Pragbhakta Kala. How is my jnana about the Dravya? It is poor. I know Jvara due to Apanavata. So, Matra and Kala. One Karsha is the Matra of Churna. So, I am giving one Karsha, that is 12 grams of Churna before food, due to involvement of Apanavata. But in Apana Vaigunya, is Guruji indicated? Granthakara said, Guruji, Jwaraharanam Sreshtam, Tikta, Tiktarasatvat, Pitta Shamanatvat. But in Apana Vaigunya related Jwara, say Malabaddhata. In Malabaddhata, there is Apana Vaigunya. Chronic constipation due to accumulation of mala in the deha leads to Ushma Vruddhi, Tapa Vruddhi. That could be Jwara. So if I use Guduchi in that particular case, is it going to relieve with the Apana? No. Being Tiktarasa, it will aggravate Vata and Apana Vaigunya continues. Still more Jwara may come. Then the information given by Granthakara is questionable. Guduchi, Jwaraharanam, Sreshtam. How? Don't know. That is why Granthakara at the end used Dravya Jnana Matam Varaha. He is Sada. Always at the peak level. He is always at the Uchasthara who has the knowledge about Dravya. So, this is again a type of literary research. We'll study another one in third chapter, Aragvadhiyam Vyakhyasyamaha. There, a charcha has been created. If a host can share this Chakrapani's verse on the first verse itself, Athato Aragvadhiyam Adhyayam Vyakhyasyamaha. Itihasmaha Atreyade Bhagavan Atreyo Atreyaha. So while commenting on this particular verse, Chakrapani has narrated. I hope host can help the viewers to see Chakrapani's opinion on this particular verse. What he says there, that Kushta Nidana is explained in Nidanasthana. Kushta Chikitsa is being explained in Chikitsasthana. Then what was the use of narrating Aragvadhiya in the beginning at the Sutrasthana itself? Abhyantara Parimarjaniya, Apamarga Tanduliya is Abhyantara Parimarjaniya. If you can read the Tika, that is very good. No, you are at the first chapter. So, anyway, till he opens, I'll just continue with the narration. What Chakrapani comments is, यद्यपि कुष्ठचिकित्सितं पृथक् एव चिकित्सास्थाने भविष्यति निदानस्थान कुष्ठनिदान ही हैज एक्सप्लेन एंड इन चिकित्सास्थान डेफिनेटली फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कुष्ठ ही हैज एक्सप्लेन कुष्ठचिकित्सितं तत्रैव च अवसर प्राप्तौ एते अरग्वदयो वक्तुम उचितः एज अपमार्ग तंडुलीय इज अभ्यंतर परिमार्जनीय रिलेटेड फैक्टर अवसर प्राप्ति. Now, Abhyantara Parimarjana has been narrated later on, as there is a chance that when internal cleaning related aspect is discussed, it is the time for discussion of Bahya related factors. That is why Bahya Parimarjana related Aragvadhiya is explained. That is what is the first Samadhana he is giving. And later he says, another Karana, Iyam cha Kushta Chikitsa Anagata Veksha Tantra Yuktyaha Anagata Vekshana Tantra Yuktyaha Nidanasthane Hetu Lakshanadi Vihi Lakshidam. In Tantra Yukti, you can go for Siddhistan 12th chapter, Siddhistan 12th chapter, where Tantra Yukti are being narrated, quotation number 41 to 44. Please keep this there only. Don't go for again Siddhistan. I'll just give reference and they can study later on. In quotation number 44, Puropada he says, Atita Anagata Veksha Swasamudnyo Hya Samuchayaha. So Atita Veksha Tantra Yukti is there. Anagata Veksha Tantra Yukti is there. What is the meaning of Atita Veksha and Anagata Veksha? Atita means past. Whatever is explained already, that we are recollecting and explaining now, that is called as Atita Veksha. Anagata Veksha, Agamana is coming, forthcoming. anagata, yet to come. That also being thought and explained now. So that is anagata viksha tantra yukti. So bahiparimarjana, though it is related with kushta, generally in Ayurveda, kushta means all skin diseases. So bahiparimarjana being the important factor for kushta chikitsa, it would have been explained in kushta chikitsitam itself. But it is anagata viksha, it is yet to come. Till then, who is, if someone forgets, if it is not the rule of grantha to miss the continuity, antaparimarjana is explained by apamarga tanduliya avasara prapto anagata viksha tantra yuktya aragvadhiyam is also being narrated. This is one of the literary research. When someone is doing research over kushta chikitsa, he should not see only kushta chikitsitam or kushta nidanam explained in charaka samhita. He is must to see third chapter of sutrasthana, that is apamarga tanduliya and aragvadhiya together. Then only he can understand kushta chikitsa properly. What is kushta chikitsa sutra? There vamana is also narrated, vatottareshu sarpihi vamanam shleshmottareshu kushteshu, like that he says. Sarpihi pana vamana virechana, how will you do without knowing the information of antaparimarjana? That is why appamarga tanduliyam is also important. So it is called atita veksha tantra yukti when you are reading kushta chikitsa. This is literary research called manuscript study. It is manuscript study. You are giving reference, right? You mentioned that in kafaja kushta, vamana is indicated. Vamana, you keep superscript and say reference numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever it is. So vamana word is used in various context. In Kalpasthana first chapter, where vamana karmukata is used, madana phaladhyaya vamana karmukata is used, siddhisthana first chapter again vamana yogya ayogya is used. In antaparimarjana again vamana yogya ayogya or vamana related factors are used. Samsarjana krama has been narrated. So one vamana word which is used in kushta chikitsa is giving its branches so many. Siddhi he is giving, nidana he is giving, vimana he is giving the information regarding vamana, sharira he is giving regarding the information of vamana while explaining about krimirogas, kalpa definitely he is giving, but even in sutra he has highlighted about vamana. So searching the word vamana and its related concepts at various places is known as type of literary research. So we'll go ahead with one more reference. In Charaka Sutra 9th chapter, Charaka Sutra 9th chapter 4th quotation, Sutrasthan 9th chapter 4th quotation, what he says, what is roga and what is arogya? While narrating about that, he has used this particular verse. Vikaro dhatu vaishamyam samyam prakritihi uchyate. Sukha saudhnyakam arogyam vikaro dukham evacha. So here important words what we need to understand is dhatu vaishamya and samya are the two important words. If you have Chakrapani Tika down, you can see dhatavaha. What is the meaning of dhatu? Dhatavaha vatadayo rasadayaha cha raja prabhrutayaha cha tesham vaishamyam. Dhatu vikaro dhatu vaishamyam. When we utter this, shishya are of three types: avara buddhi, madhyama buddhi, pravara buddhi. Avara buddhi shishya, what he'll say? Vikara means dhatu vaishamya, rasa to shukra only, there will be vishamata. That is roga. Samyam, if all dhatus are sama, then that is arogya. But it is not so. Tikshna buddhi person like Chakrabani will understand it in a different way. Vikaro dhatu vaishamyam, धातवः इति शब्देन वातादयो रसादयः च तथा रजप्रभृतयः. See how great the research he has carried out. He says धातु never mean only शारीरिक. He has used रजप्रभृतयः. That means मानसिक factor also he has utilized while narrating. What is the base to say धातु means not only रस, not only रसादि धातु, not only वातादि दोष, but even रज and तम. Because for that the reference is again back in Sutrasthan 1. Sattvamatma shariram cha trayam etat tridandavat. Sattva, Atma and Sharira. These three are most needed, where Sattva means Manas. One more reference we can get from Charaka Samhita itself, that Shariram janu vidhiyate sattvam sattvam shariram. If you think about some vyadhi continuously, definitely the vyadhi utpatti of that particular comes. Say jwara. Somehow climate is very bad, cool breeze, raining everywhere. So I may get jwara. You are going to definitely get jwara. I'll give literary reference for this. You can go to Charaka Chikitsa Sthan, third chapter, Sutra Kramank 114. Charak Chikitsa Sthan, third chapter, that is Jwara Chikitsitam, Sutra Sankhya 114. Kama Shoka Bhayakrodhaihi Abhishiktasya Yojwaraha So Abhishanga Jwarodneyo Yascha Bhuta Abhishangajaha. Shoka, Kama, Bhaya, Krodha, etc. factors will cause vitiation of Sharirika Dhatu. Later, the continuations, he says, Kama Shoka Bhayat Vayuhu, Krodhat Pittam, Trayomalaha. Yes, very much thankful to the team that they are depicting all sutras. So what he says? Kama, Shoka and Bhaya leads to Vayu. Vayu Prakopa. Then Krodha leads to Pitta Prakopa. Trayaha Malaha. Similarly, remaining, it is our duty by applying Arthapati Tantra Yukti or Vakyashesha Tantra Yukti, we have to understand for other doshas also. Trayo Malaha. So, this kamana, shoka and bhaya or chintana, atichintana of particular thing, definitely we are going to aggravate or get vitiated with the dosha. That leads to what? Dosha vikriti. Vikrita dosha will hamper the routine activity of the deha, leads to vyadhi utpatti. So, kama shoka bhayad vayu krodhat pittam trayomalaha. When it is mentioned, it is only mentioned for Vruddhatmaka Prakopa. Prakopa of Vayu, Pitta and Kapha, all three malas due to these psychological factors is in the meaning of Vruddhi. But Prakopa can be Kshaya also. Kshaya can also be the meaning of Prakopa. For that, the reference is from Charaka, Sharirasthan, 6th chapter, quotation number 17. Charaka, Sharirasthan, 6th chapter, quotation number 17. There, can you open Charaka Sharira 6th chapter? Yes. There, Chakrapani's explanation is most important. Charak Sharir, chapter 6, quotation number 17. Then at the last, तद्यथा शरीर छिद्रेषु उपदेहाः पृथक् जन्मानो बहिर्मुखाः परिपक्वाः च धातवाः प्रकुपिताः च वातपित्तश्लेष्मणाः. सी इन मूलसूत्र डिड यू गेट या यू आर एट द राइट पाथ. इन मूलसूत्र प्रकुपिताः च वात पित्त श्लेष्माणः, थ्री दोषा ओनली ही हैज यूज्ड. ये च अन्ये अपि केचित् शरीरे तिष्ठन्तो भावः, एंड लेटर ही कंटिन्यू, ये च अन्ये अपि तिष्ठन्तो शरीर भावः, देर आर अदर भावास, भाव मीन्स एग्जिस्टिंग थिंग्स इन द शरीर विच आर ऑल्सो कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग इन द व्याधि उत्पत्ति. फॉर दैट कमेंटिंग ऑन प्रकृति Chakrapani has narrated beautifully kupitaha cha iti padena. Down you can come. Kupitaha cha iti padena. There in the same verse, I think fourth or fifth line of Chakrapani's narration. Kupitaha cha iti padena vatadayaha samanyena kshina vriddha vagrahyante. Excellent. Kupita means vayu kopa, kupita vayu leading to katishula. What do we understand generally? It is clinical understanding. Kupita means vruddhi, but it is not so. Kupita hacha iti padena vatadayaha. See, it is not on special grounds. He has used particularly, purposefully the word samanyena, generally, not specially. Generally, kupita means either it can be kshina or vruddhi. Apigrihyante. Later he continues and says, vikriti matram hi kopaha. Kopa means kopastu unmargagamitvam. Kopastu unmargagamitvam. So, vikriti in general is known as kopa. So with this literature of Granthakara, what can we draw Siddhanta out of this literature study is, vyadhi can occur because of dosha vruddhi as well as dosha kshaya, not only dosha vruddhi. Even dosha kshaya will definitely cause vyadhi. So that was the intention of Chakrapani giving samanyena. If it was, he would have used visheshena, kshina varuddha vagrihyante, if it was used, then we could get the information that on special grounds, some exceptional cases there may be. But he has used so gratefully samanyena. It is not uncommon, it is very common. Kopa means, or kupita means, not only vriddhi, it is kshaya also. Now, we can go back to Charaka Sutra 9th chapter again to read dhatavaha vikaro dhatu vaishamyam samyam prakriti ruchyate sukha saudhnyakam arogyam vikaro dukham evacha. Vikriti means what he has used, vikara shabda there. Vikara is akaranta pullinga, vikara shabda. Vikriti is also pullinga, giving same meaning. So here he has used dhatu vaishamya. That means vatadi dosha, rasadi dhatu, rajadi manodosha, either vruddhi or kshaya will lead to dosha or vyadhi. So this is literary research. What was the research we did? Dhatu was the word. What is the meaning of dhatu? We studied from the same Chakrapani's narration, but vikara shabda we understood from Sharirasthan. Now another, dhatu means whether only Vatadi, why are we considering in this particular verse he might have used it, but there will be somewhere wherein he may not be using it. There would be a question. For that, another reference we can get from Charaka Sutra, chapter 1. Charaka Sutra, chapter 1, wherein he is narrating quotation number 67. Charaka Sutra, chapter 1. Quotation number 67, there he said, Kinchit dosha prashamanam. Yeah, we have to see the tika then. Kinchit dosha prashamanam, kinchit dhatu pradushanam, swastha vrittav matam kinchit trividham dravya muchate. Dravya is of three types. In dosha, yes, vyadhi, we understood. In concept of dravya also he is narrating. Dhatu means not only rasadi dhatu. He has used doshasya dosha dosha yohonam va prashamanam dosha prashamanam dosha grahanena dushta rasadayo api grahyante. Did you get in Chakrapani's narration? Yes, there only. I think a second line in the dosha grahanena drishta rasadayo api grahyante. Drishta means we could see it. Dosha shabda never mean only vatadi. Dosha shabda means even rasadi. So dhatu is also similar. Dhatu means not only rasadi. Dhatu means dosha also. So this is called as Atita Veksha Tantra Yukti, and applying that Tantra Yukti, we could understand the previous to the existing context. Now, this Rogotpatti we understood that due to Vriddhi or Kshaya, Rogotpatti takes place. How this Roga tend to cause Vyadhi? There are some various Nidana with which Vyadhi occurs. For that, two important factors we are supposed to study from Charaka, Vimanasthan, 6th chapter. Charaka, Vimanasthan, 6th chapter. What he says there, Tatra, Anubandhya, Anubandhakruto, Visheshaha. Viman 6th chapter, quotation number 11. Quotation number 11. Can you zoom it? Yeah. Yes. Tatra anubandhya anubandhakrataha visheshaha swatantro vyaktalingo yathokta samuthana prashamo bhavanti anubandhyaha tasya artat viparita lakshanastvam anubandhaha. Yes, what he says there, swatantra and paratantra are the two important factors. While studying nidana, we have studied hetu is of two types. One is swatantra hetu, another one is paratantra. Or in the concept of dosha dushti, we have studied two factors, swatantra dosha dushti, paratantra dosha dushti. Then what are they? Swatantraha vyaktalingaha. Particular causative factor say ativyayama is vayu prakopaka. So vyayama is causative factor for the vata vikriti. Then what lakshana it exhibits? Shuladi. Sarvanga shula or here there pain. This shula is vatasya lakshana. Swatantraha vyaktalingaha yathokta samuthanaha. Where do we feel the pain? At the vatasthana. Pada is vatasthana. We get pain. Joints. shira, vatasthana, we start getting the pain. Then, yathokta samuthana. Then, prashamana, how does it get subsided? By doing svedana. By doing snehana, abhyanga, pralepa, pradeha, which are vatashamaka. The vatashamana takes place. So, that particular factor is denoted as anubandhya. Anubandhya means swatantra. Its own causes, its own lakshanas, its own place, and it is getting subsided by its own factors, own treatment principles. Vatasya upakramena vatashamanam drishyate. So this is anubandhya or swatantra. Paratantra is viparita. How we should understand? You apply virodha shabda to whatever is explained. Asvatantro vyaktalingaha ayathokta samuthana prashamo bhavanti anubandhaha. Asvatantra. Causative factor is something different. And vruddhi or vikriti of dosha is something different. We must see as literature, we have to do a search for this. Do we have any reference for such pathology wherein causative factor is something and vikriti is seen in some other dosha? Definitely we have. Nidanasthana, third chapter, that is Gulma Nidana, we can get beautiful reference for this. This is again a what is called as literary research. Now we were studying Anubandha and Anubandhya. Our study was entitled on Swatantra and Aswatantra Dosha Drushti. So while doing this literature or the study on this particular concept, we came to know that Anubandhya means Swatantra Linga, Swatantra Karana, Swatantra Sthana and Swatantra Prashamana Karana, with which it does pacify and turns to a normal. So do we have any reference? The question, what it comes there, that itself when you go back or go ahead and search, that is known as literary research. We have reference for this. Charaka, Nidanasthan, third chapter, sixth quotation, what he says, yada purusho vatalo visheshena jvara vamana virechana atisaranam anyatamena karshanena karshitaha vatalam aharam aharati. You didn't get? Go down. Next quotations. Quotation number 6. Quotation number 6. There he says, yada purusho vatalo visheshena jvara vamana virechana atisaranam anyatamena karshanena karshito vatalam aharati. You can see all those references. All are vata prakopa karana. At the end what he says, evam vidham vishamam atimatram vyayama jatam arabhate. At the last, tasya apacharat vataha prakopam apadyate. Down. Tasya apachara vataha prakopam apadyate. Due to these nidana and other nidana which are similar to this, if we perform, then vata prakopam apadyate. Vata prakopam takes place. Yes. So, what all nidana he has enlisted? Vamana he has enlisted. Ati vamana will lead to vata prakopa, because kafakshaya takes place. Ati virechana, again kafakshaya, jala mahabhuta kshaya takes place. Vayu mahabhuta aggravates, vata prakopa can be seen. Shitala ahara or vatakara ahara vihara sevana definitely aggravates vata. So we understood all nidana which are vata particularly aggravating factors. They are known as swatantra karanas. Now go further to the pitta prakopaka nidanas. That is quotation number 8. Quotation number 8 in the same chapter. What he says, Taihi evatu karshanaihi karshitasya amla lavana katuka kshara ushna tikshna shushka vyapannam madhya aharita falanam amlanam vidahinam cha shakadhanya mausadinam upayogat ajirna adhyashana etc. etc. At the end, dharanam vata atapaucha atisevya manasya pittam saha marutena prakopam apajati. See? Vibhakti, little bit of Shastriya Vyakarana is there in this understanding for the literary research. At the end, what he is saying, cha atiseva manasya pittam saha marutena prakopam apajati. Pittam. If you are using pitta as pullinga vachaka shabda, then Ramaha Ramau Ramaha Ramam Ramau Ramana Ramam. That is Dvitiya Vibhakti we are considering. Pitta Pitto Pittaha Pittam Pitto Pittana Pittam Dvitiya Vibhakti. What it is giving? Pittako to the Pitta is the meaning when it is used as a Dvitiya Vibhakti. This Pitta aggravates due to what? Marutena. You can highlight the word. Marutena. Tritiya Vibhakti he is using. What is Tritiya Vibhakti meaning? Due to this. Tena Pratyaya is there. When Tena Pratyaya is used, it means due to this, because of this culprit, this Pitta is getting aggravated. So what is the meaning? Karana is all Vata. But aggravating dosha is Pitta. So this is known as Paratantra Dosha Dushti. You got it? Anyone can unmute and tell, or if you have any query, you can raise at this particular verse, at this particular explanation. Was that clear about Swatantra and Paratantra? Nobody is replying.
Anyone, please unmute yourself.
If it is not clear, would make another attempt to clear it again.
Clear, sir.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good. So, the Anubandha is explained in Vimanasthana, wherein Anubandha means Swatantra Karana, Anubandha means Viparita, that is Aswatantra Karana. Is there any literary work over this? Yes, definitely there. Where it is? In Nidanasthana. So this is type of literary study. We were studying Swatantra Dosha Dushti or Anubandha and Anubandha. While studying Anubandha and Anubandha, we came to know about the words Swatantra and Paratantra. To understand Swatantra and Paratantra, we went back to Nidanasthana and tried understanding about Swatantra Dosha Dushti Karana and Swatantra Lakshana and Paratantra Dosha Dushti Karana and Paratantra Dosha Selakshana. You can see the Lakshana in Pittaja Unmada, that is quotation number 9. What he says, Lakshanas, Tat Pragubidam Marutaha Amashayashe Ekadesha Samvartya Taneva Vedana Prakaran Upajayati Ya Ukta Vata Gulme Pittam Tuyena Vidahati Daha Kuksham Hrudi Urasi Kantecha Vidahyamanaha. Daha is seen at all these places. GERD. Patient says, Chhati mein jalta hai. Retrosternal burning. We understand it as, it is due to pitta. So what we start giving? Amla pitta hara. Such as madhur rasa. Kashaya is best in pitta shamana. So we start giving kashaya. Amla ki kashaya you take. Pittahara dravya, bhunim badi kashaya you take. But kashaya is vata vardhaka. Causative factor is something different. That is vata. this is literary research again. I hope I could take to the depth of literary research in a different angle. Generally, what we study in textbooks is bit different. In the research books, we can get a lot of information regarding literary research, cataloging, manuscripts, puranas, digital libraries, center-related libraries. There, you collect information from various aspects. So that is what is known as research. This is generally known literary research. But how it is done from Samhitas, I tried in a different angle to convey. I am closing my explanation on literary research as of now. I have been requested by Lochan to discuss about a few concepts like Panchavayava Vakya and Rasa. Shadrasa is the ultimate, that is what is substantiated by Atreya Punarvasu, and he does khandana of Ekarasa, Dvirasa, Chaturrasa, Pancharasa, Shadrasa, Saptarasa, Ashtarasa, Trayodasharasa, like that various number of rasas he does khandana and he does mandana, that there are only six rasas existing. Those two factors he had asked me to. I would take that particular explanation on a different occasion other than this literary research. Any query you have over literary research, I would definitely be open to answer. Or any suggestion for myself to correct, I'm definitely accepting it and improvise my explanation over literary research.
Thank you so much, sir, for making us clear on the topic. We have some of the questions from the participants. The very first question is about data management system in ancient text. What is the data management system in ancient text?
Definitely. The basic meaning of this data management itself is collecting, compiling, and propagating. See, data management, we have information regarding some particular concepts. Say, tatra ruksho lagu shita khara sukshmas chalo anilaha. These are the qualities of Vayu or Vata dosha, which are explained in Ashtanga Hridaya. They are compiled, they are studied well by Ashtanga Hridaya Kara there. Then it was also understood by Madhyakalina Grantha like Sharangadhara, and it is even practiced now that Uttarakalina Grantha like Priyavrat Sharma's various texts. So when the same concept is collected, documented, and it is propagated, that itself is data management. That is how they manage. And they try to convey, say, a good example would be Ashtanga Hridayam for this data management. Some data from Sushruta he has collected. Few data from Charaka he has collected. He has compiled and understood well about the particular concept and documented. So that we get both the information of Sushruta as well as Charaka at one roof. So this itself is a very good contribution of Ashtanga Hridayakara over data management. Any other question?
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. By this, we end our class for today.
Yeah.
Dear participants, we have another class of Anatomy of Nervous System and Neurophysiology by Janak Awasthi, sir. You can join through your email or through the link in the chat box below that we have given in the chat box here in the screen. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us.
I'm requesting the host to give the actual feedback. Don't take me that you have invited me. If you give negative feedback, then there will be difficulty what the person can feel. No, I'm definitely not going to feel as that. Any wrong matter, if it is conveyed or not conveyed in a proper way, you can please intimate me so that I can improvise always and come back to you.
Sure, sir. I will get the feedback from all the participants and send you later.
Yes, definitely, definitely. We'll be waiting for you all. Thank you. Thank you
again.
Anena bhavi yat punyam tadapnotu gurur. Dhanyawad.